Well, hello, my brothers and sisters. This is Brother West, Prophet West, coming back to you again. I was meditating, and as I was driving to work, one of the things that God allowed me to see and is that we're in a new dimension. You're in a new dimension. You're standing in a new dimension. And what I saw was standing in a field, and in this field there was a lot. In this field, there were fruit. There were things to glean from vegetables and fruits and stuff like that in this field. And what God was saying to me was that in this new field, in this new place, and in this new dimension, there's a new attitude, there's a new behavior that you must operate in, meaning that the warfare and how you did, how you talked, how you fought before, you can't do that in this place because it's a different place. And in this different place, there's new challenges, different encounters, and the stakes are higher. They're different. And so, just like the Bible said, how can you pour new wine in old bottles? You can't do that because it'll burst. And so, so you have to change your approach. You have to change your mindset. You have to change your attitude, because your attitude will determine your altitude, your level. And so in this place, you can't face when challenges come. You can't face them like you faced them before. You have to seek God, and you have to prepare. You have to prepare, and preparation is in you by your relationship with God, which means that God has put things in you, but it's up to you to tap within and allow those things to come forth. There are certain things that God has developed in you, and so now it's time for those things to become developed, or for those things to speak forth. See, in your struggles, your pain, when you're going through the wars, the tribulations, and the trials, it was developing this particular thing for this particular season and for this particular dimension. But for in this dimension, there's a different language, there's a different sound, there's a different warfare that God has given you. So prepare, prepare, prepare. Focus, focus, focus. Don't look to the past, but look within and look toward God, because in this place where you're at now, it's time to pick up, it's time to gather, it's time to glean. For the harvest is plenteous and the labors are few. For there's an attack against the people of God, but we must be ready. You must use your voice, and your voice is with praise. This is the place where God wants you to use your voice. Praise, because praise is the very thing that's your weapon. Your weapon of war, your weapon of warfare. Praise is your battle axe, your praise, along with worship. Worship is that intimate time, that quiet time, that secret time, wherein it's like being in the filler station. It's like being refueled. In your worship, God will refuel you. In your praise, God will cause your voice to come forth. He will cause that fire to come out of your mouth. It's just like when you go to when you're traveling on a trip, you have to go to the gas station when you get low on gas to fill up, in order to go towards your destination. See, the fuel up is your worship. The fuel up is your personal relationship and your life with God. It's the fuel that's gauging and just preparing you that when you open up your mouth, you will have a relationship. You will speak. The relationship that you have with God will speak. And see what happened. That's why the Bible says, what you do in secret, God will reward you openly for. In other words, your private time with God. See, just like with David. See, David, he was tending sheep, but it was his private time. But in his private time, he was doing big things. See, people didn't know nothing about what he was doing because it was in his private time, until the time came that he was put on the scene. Then the world will see what was in him. And see, this is the place where God has summoned and called you to come forth. He's called you out of the cave. He's prepared you while you were in the cave. And so now he's calling you to come out, Elijah. He's calling you to come out. So it's time to speak with power and with demonstration. It's time to speak with force. The Bible said, since the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and the violent taketh by force. See, in this particular place, in this harvest, in this new dimension, it's a dimension where God wants you to take. He's saying to pursue, and you are going to recover all. This is your hour, and this is your season of recovery. total recovery. What the locust and the cankerworms have eaten up, God said, I'm going to restore back to you. He's not going to give it, but you're going to take it. You're going to go to the enemy's camp like David did and took it. And you shall recover all in this season. In this season, be prepared. In this season, be ready. In this season, have your weapon ready to fight. Have your weapon ready. Have it ready and be ready. In Jesus' name, God bless you.